everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing a photo shoot. It's more so for content and stuff for my Instagram, but I think it's my first episode on YouTube is about a photo shoot I did 2 years ago where I had kind of a bad experience with it and dieting up towards it and things like that. So if you want to check that out, that is episode one. But this time around, it's really, really nice because I haven't specifically dieted for this photo shoot. However, I have been in a dieting phase for the last 8 weeks, but I booked this photo shoot on a whim and I wasn't dieting for the photo shoot, if that makes sense. I'm actually more so dieting for a holiday I'm going on in summer. But yeah, I was just like, do you know what? I need more content for my Instagram. I'm just going to book a photo shoot. And it's just mad, my mindset towards it now. Like, I don't see the need to get ready for a photo shoot. Excuse the tan on my hands. It's disgusting. Yeah, it's really exciting and it's really fun. Like, it's like, it's really weird, like, not like fully dieting up to a photo shoot. Like, my last one was just crazy. Like, I was literally barely eating, like doing crazy exercise. It wasn't enjoyable at all. So I'm really excited now to do this one and vlog it, and I'm really excited to experience it with lots of energy, lots of food in me, and nice and fueled. So I have my first outfit on. I need to go soon because I am under pressure. Yeah, it's 7:05, so I kind of need to go because I'm meeting Poddy at 7:30. But I'm going to show you my outfit that I'm wearing now. So guys, I'm wearing the new tempo from the new tempo set from my protein. It's absolutely gorgeous. I love it. Love it so, so, so much. Yeah, it's really nice. I know, like, you can't really see in this, but they have like really nice detail along the bum. It's almost like a contour kind of. Really, really, really love. I also have the socks. They're my staple. Go with everything. So guys, Poddy is just taking a candid picture of me while I'm vlogging in my element, in my natural habitat, so to say. Everyone, so it is the evening time. I didn't get a chance to vlog most of the shoot, to be honest. I had to vlog on my phone because my camera died, which is so annoying. So I'll know to bring my camera charger anymore, but the shoot was absolutely unreal. Like, it was so good, and in comparison to my old shoot, like, it was just, yeah, it was unreal. I felt so happy because I suppose I had worked on myself for so long internally, and it was just really nice to not worry about like having abs or trying to be the skinniest girl in the room. Like, it was so nice to be just so happy in my own skin. Like, honestly, like, I didn't care what size I was because I was just happy from the inside, which took so long to do. And I suppose in saying that, like, it is a constant work in progress. Obviously I have really bad body image days. Obviously I have shit days with my food and things like that, but I suppose it's absolutely nothing compared to what I used to have. And I've become so self-aware on my journey through body image, repairing my body image and my relationship with food. And if anyone is watching this now who is having a really shit time with restrictive eating, binge eating, really bad negative body image, and thinking that losing weight helps that, for me it didn't. For me it heightened all my insecurities. My body image was my lowest when I was my slimmest. I was cold, I was hungry. I never enjoyed my last shoot. It was just pure based on how I looked, and I just didn't enjoy any of it. This shoot, I just enjoyed every second. I was able to be present, I was able to be myself. It was great crack, we were having such a laugh, and all the pictures are so natural, which I really, really like. So yeah, it's a really nice pivotal moment, I suppose, for me, on how far I've come. And I'm just, yeah, I'm really proud of myself, and I'm so happy I'm able to say that I'm really proud of myself as well. So yeah, but then we went to the Tip and Clear match afterwards, the hurling match, and I'm literally just home now, so I'm gonna get a bite to eat. But I'm gonna extend this vlog, I'm gonna say, for the next few days. So I'm gonna bring you along on the next few days, and it'll probably just be, most of my vlogs will probably just be like that, like kind of a couple of days together, trying together of what I do, what I get up to, which isn't that much, being honest, at the minute, because I finally have exams. And when I'm doing my coaching work, I'm usually just sitting at a laptop, so we might have like a workout or something thrown in here, I really don't know yet. But stay tuned, and I'll talk to you all soon. Also guys, this was my outfit today. Converse, mom Zara jeans, which I really, really like, and I got this little cute little basic crop top in Zara. I'm a very plain dresser. I also got these glasses from Penny's. So yeah, I always like seeing what people wear on YouTube, but like I never wear clothes like this ever. Never wear casual clothes, like ever. It's either gym gear or like a dress for going out, and there's no in between. But I actually kind of like it. I like wearing normal clothes. So then I do it more often. Guys, my camera keeps dying, which is so annoying. So if anyone has tips on that, please let me know. I'll probably have to get like a power bank for it or something, because every time I go to vlog, it's dead. Yeah, it's really annoying. But anyways, I'm off on my morning walk. Here is the fit. Beaut. I know. This is actually good. Like, this is like, usually I look crazier. So I always just pick what the first thing is in the wardrobe, comfiest thing. And this is what we're looking like. Guys, I get Costa coffee, but it's not my favourite. My favourite is Starbucks, but when you live in somewhere like Bird Hill, having a Costa is actually massive, so yeah. Sorry guys, that background and light was actually really annoying me, but basically my aunt just said to try other things before I go on Roctan, so I was getting laser done in therapy in the Crescent in Limerick, and I asked them about it, and I went on Skin Acumax, and they're these tablets that you can take while doing laser still, and I took those from like last September, and I'm still taking them now currently, but they hugely helped. It took about 3 months for me to start to see a difference and for my skin to start to clear a bit. And then what I started doing then was, once all the acne had kind of like dried up, I started doing chemical peels and in therapy as well with Nikita. And then and now my next step is microneedling. But like, honestly, I'm not gonna go too close up because I'm obviously still conscious of it, but I just got a chemical peel done last Thursday, and oh my god, the difference already is absolutely insane. Like, I am left with some scarring and it has dried up like some of my active acne that was there, but honestly the difference in my skin is absolutely insane. And I now actually have a skin routine, which I never used to have because I completely took my skin for granted before, because I never suffered like with acne or spots or anything like that. Obviously I had a couple of spots here and there around my time of the month, and obviously through puberty and stuff, but I never experienced like cystic acne like what I had, and oh my god, my confidence just went down through the floor with it. Yeah, it was awful. Like, I was crying, I was so insecure, I had to wear makeup everywhere, and literally when I was wearing it, it looked even worse. Like, it would like highlight the spots. Like, it was just awful. So yeah, I'm so grateful to the girls in therapy in the Crescent for helping me out. And by the way guys, this is not like sponsored. I pay for all my stuff. It's not me, like I don't work with them, but I'm just so grateful to all of the girls in Silent Therapy who have helped me so much, and they're so nice, they're absolute dolls. So yeah, that's my little kind of skin journey. I didn't know I was gonna, no, I think I said I would talk about it on this vlog, but yeah, I'm gonna go do my journaling, read, start my check-ins, and I will chat to you later. So guys, hello, it is Wednesday today, training with Eva today. I'm training posterior, Eva's training pole, so it's kind of the same thing. Eva just won PCA junior bikini.
So I'm just out of my first show there about 10 days ago. We did the PCA in Scotland.
Yeah.
Doing peak week now.
Again,
so my second peak week in preparation for my second show, which is this Sunday, up in Derry, the PCA Irish Open. So it's a busy week this week, but
you have exams as well.
I have exams as well, yeah.
I do as well, actually, final year exams. One next week and two assignments.
So it's peak week, it's exam week.
That's mad, like.
We have to train pull.
Oh, how do you feel though?
No, I'm actually feeling like so good this
week.
Like, not nervous at all, which is crazy, like so crazy, because it's just such an experience. Like, the journey has just been surreal. So I'm so excited now.
What's your Instagram handle? Eva.maher, is it?
Maher.eva.
Okay, I'll actually leave it below so you can follow her journey. No, because it's actually been unreal so far. So like, we didn't even give a background, but me and Eva have been in school together since we were like first year. And we've been friends the whole way up. We used to play rugby together.
days. Oh my gosh.
Lads, we'd some crack doing that now, to be fair. Like, it was actually unreal. But basically we've been friends the whole way up. And no, we actually got really friendly in TY, remember? We were put together in a room for skiing.
Yeah.
And that's how we got so friendly.
Everyone just kinda came out of their shed, I think, in TY.
Yeah.
Everyone got to know each other, it was so nice.
Yeah, we had some crack. We actually did, didn't we?
Yeah.
Like Newport.
It was just Newport life. Oh, I'd love to go back.
Yeah, for one or two days. Yeah, like, we actually did have such good crack. But, and then Eva, you got into the gym when?
So I started training. Basically, I started training like a year and a half ago.
That's mad. It was a year and a half ago.
At the start of lockdown. Is that a year and a half ago? The very first lockdown.
Oh my God, it feels like so much longer.
The first time I was like, right, I want to change. So I remember I text you.
Yeah, I remember.
So I actually text Kate and was like,
I want to do this. I actually vividly remember that.
I was like, Kate, I need to go to the gym. I want to train. Can you recommend me a coach? So she did.
Oh my God.
She recommended Adam.
I can't believe that was... Oh my God, I actually vividly remember those voice notes.
Yeah, and so I did. I got in touch. And honestly, like, I've never looked back.
Well, you fucking won! Your first, like, won her first ever bikini competition. Like, so PCA as well. PCA. That's so recognised, like.
Yeah, so my first PCA. It was hard at the start, though, because I started off, like, I didn't have access to a gym. It was all home workouts. And that's so hard, like, it was so lonely. It was so hard to keep motivated.
Yeah.
But I did that.
You can't rely on motivation. You know that.
Yeah.
You can't.
But no, stuck with it. Did my first photo shoot then last year. So that was like my first big goal. Okay, let's go do this. Something to do during lockdown. So I did that. Did that in March.
And Eva, just like a quick like disclaimer, like, guys, Eva, like, your relationship with food and your body image, tell people about that, like.
So basically, like, my relationship with food is actually so fine.
Yeah.
Like, so fine. Like, I wouldn't recommend doing these bodybuilding or photoshoot diets if your relationship with food is not fine, because you can only stay in condition like this for so long and you need to reverse yourself slowly out of it. Now, I've been through the process already. I know what needs to be done.
I've done a gaining phase.
So, like, after my first photoshoot last year, I did my first gaining phase. I gained for 8 months until Christmas. But the process behind it, like, I know you put on fat, that's fine, but you can see the muscle growth as well. But you have to understand that you need to eat and gain weight in order to put on the muscle. So yeah, I did that up until Christmas.
And like, your body image and your relationship with food hasn't changed, like, you, like, no. During that gaining phase, like, what you just knew, like, that was what you needed to do, and you know that this physique that you have now isn't sustainable. Like, you know that, don't you?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Like, I was, like, told, basically, that if I wanted to compete, I needed to put on tissue. So I was like, right, this needs to be done. Like, I need to eat my calories. I need to eat my protein. I need to train hard, lift heavy. You know, I need to put on the weight, gain tissue. And I did come Christmas. You could see it. Like, under the body fat, you can see the tissue gained. And it was then, after Christmas, then I started my cut. And I've been cutting since then, so I think I'm maybe 16 weeks on a cut.
Yeah.
But I'm coming to the end of it now. I've only a couple of weeks left with two more shows to do. And yeah, I'll be back out of this condition. So obviously, slowly reverse first.
Yeah.
And then I'll go into an improvement phase again.
Yeah.
In preparation for the next book. Yeah. So that's
and like,
so exciting.
Are you excited for that? Yeah, you're so excited for that.
Like,
yeah.
I understood the first time, like, what needed to be done for a bulk, but I understand it even more now.
How
so
important
so
it is.
So excited to do it again. Like.
Yeah, but guys, I suppose it was just important for us to note that Eva's, like, I could never do what Eva's doing. Like, I need to put that out there. I could never, ever do that because of how far I've come with my relationship with food and my body image. And like, that's something I actually am still actively improving on. So you need to understand that we've both came from like completely different backgrounds with our relationship with food and body image. And for one person, it's absolutely fine. Like Eva, where her relationship with food and her body image is A1.
Yeah.
Like absolutely A1. And I could never do that show because I'd never put my relationship with food or body image at risk after what I've been through.
Like, girls do go through a lot after doing these bikini shows or these bodybuilding shows. Like, they do get, like, so mentally
attached, I suppose.
Like, to their physique, to the abs, to, like, just everything, how lean you are. And they go through a lot, like, and they end up binge eating and putting on loads of weight too fast. Like, yes, you have to gain weight, but you don't want to binge eat after.
No.
It's just really bad place to be. But for some girls, that does happen.
Yeah, but you just know, like, you know you. Like, you know you best.
Exactly.
So, yeah, it's just good for, like, it's really actually nice that, like, it to show, like, two different sides. And, like, I suppose if this was old Kate, like, and I hadn't come so far with my body image and my relationship with food, like, I'd actually be triggered by Eva. Like, I actually would, because...
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's
isn't that mad? Like, I actually would have been triggered by you if this was me this time last year, because I was so insecure in myself and, like, my body image and my relationship with food was so horrific. I would have been actually triggered, whereas now I've came so far with that, like, I'm not. Do you know what I mean? But I just know I couldn't do that.
That's amazing that you've come so far.
And it's so cool to see someone who can actually just do that. Do you know what I mean? I'm like, whoa, that's so cool. Like, you know, so it's actually so cool. So we're going to leave this go. That was a nice little intro.
It was.
And we're going to take Kate's, you through our session.
She's about to annihilate me through.
Woo! Absolutely buzz. It's actually Eva's first time in the fitness factory.
Oh my god, yeah. I'm actually so excited.
Ooh, yeah.
Okay, we're in the fitness factory now. I'll actually show it to you.
Ah! I hope I'm doing this right. I'm so bad.
So we're in the fitness factory now. Our first exercise is Jenny's actually on it, Jenny Percy. So fuck you, Jenny. No, I'm joking. So we're gonna start with upper back pull down, then go into a rear delt cable fly. Oh, the cable starts free. Woo! Get it. Go get it.
Till I get up, time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left.
It's Jenny again. We're in Fitness Factory, and we met Jenny.
Hello.
No, it's so funny. We're literally just talking about the Manchester vlog, because obviously it's the first one we did, and Jenny said that didn't he all sit down and watch it?
Yes, my whole family. So the big screen.
And unsubscribe from Kate's channel, subscribe to my channel, actually got all the information.
Success. Turn around, breath. Keane O'Brien.
What?
What are you training?
Density. Nasty.
You fucked.
Is that Kate for Kate?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm fucked.
What do you think it's for?
I'm actually just back full volume now for the first time in like 3 weeks, so.
Feeling good?
Feeling good. Feeling very good. Like a brand new shampoo.
Class.
And on we'll go.
guys. This is Ethan.
Hello. How are you? My name is Ethan, Ethan O'Brien. I'm also a friend of Kate's and I'm glad to make my debut on her vlog.
And your coach.
And my hashtag coaching, what is it, username?
Yeah.
ET coaching, so everyone make sure to follow.
On Instagram.
On Instagram.
We'll pop it below.
Yes.
Hey guys, we are just back from the gym. Myself and Eva trained posterior. Really, really good session. I was up on my barbell RDL by 5 kg, which was cool. I actually used to get really, really bad back pain doing RDLs. Like severely bad last year in Tenerife especially, was the worst it was. And Dermot, my coach at the time, was helping me through that. And basically what we did was, now obviously like this is so different for different people, like, so don't take this advice like from me. If you're experiencing back pain, go to your doctor or go to a physio. But what I did for me and what worked for me was, I'd been to physio before with it and she said like I can still train with it, but she was like, just be very, very careful doing RDLs, like don't go too heavy on them. And I didn't, but I was still experiencing pain. So then we took them out for a while and I just love RDLs, like I love them, they're like one of my favorite movements. And I was like, Dermot, can we try them again? And he was like, yeah, okay, cool, let's try them. So we popped them in again and I was just experiencing like really bad discomfort and still pain there. And he was like, look, just train through the pain and try not to associate pain with the barbell RDL. Like try, just, I know this sounds mad, but he was like, try to forget about it. And I was like, what? Like, I was like, okay. So I stopped kind of like associating pain with the barbell RDL, because before my session, I'd dread it and I'd be like, oh my God, my back's going to be sore. My back's going to be sore. So I was kind of training through it and like very light weights training through it. And I just did that for so long and the pain went away. Mad. I actually remember though Gary McGowan talking about that on the Muscle Mentors Education Portal. There was like a session and I remember he was like, they were talking about pain, and Gary is a coach, and he's actually a qualified physio as well. And I just remember him saying like, sometimes it's in your head a bit. Like, I just remember him saying that, something like along those lines, like that sometimes it can be in your head, like that you're saying to yourself like something about the pain receptors like attached to what you're saying to yourself in your head. Like, it's like, yeah, something like along those lines. And that really resonated with me then, and he was kind of talking through it. So that's kind of the method behind the madness of that. Now obviously, don't go and just do that. Like, obviously go to your doctor or physio first if you are experiencing any pain like that. But touch wood, I haven't had any pain since. It's fine as keepers. It's fine as keepers. Stop doing your digital on me. Cause I don't need a spiritual journey. Boy, you ain't living in fear. You don't live around here. Let's make peace all the time. Hello everyone, it is Sunday the 1st of May, which is really cool. So I always set out like loads of goals for each month. So I need to set out my goals for this month, for the month of May. But it is, so the Sunday after the shoot, so I'm actually going to the hurling match today. It's Cork and Clare. So basically hurling is like, I think I said that already in this vlog, hurling is like Ireland's national sport, and the championship is on at the minute and it's unreal. There's something on every, like there's a match on every Sunday and it's such a buzz. Yeah, it's so good. But I'm just doing a little outro to this vlog. I'm ending it here. I hope you enjoyed it. And I just wanted to tell you as well that I never really explained the background to my skin. So basically, and like how I got cystic acne. So how I got it was from coming off of the contraceptive injection. I never really had any problems with my skin before this, like as in
yeah, I get spots and stuff, but like it was nothing like what I had gotten. And to be honest, like I didn't really take much pictures of when it was really, really bad because I was just so self-conscious of it. But if you even see at the start of the video, like you can see like there's a lot of dry skin around my chin, if you notice that. And that's literally just from the chemical peel that I did a couple of weeks, I think it was 2 weeks ago. Or was it last week? No, it was 2 weeks ago, I think. But yeah, they're really, really helping, like I said. But yeah, if anyone is going through the same thing, like, and wants to message me, just shoot me a DM on Instagram. And I can tell you what helped. For me, obviously, I've kind of said that already. But yeah. But I just really hope you enjoyed this vlog. I'm still getting so used to vlogging, like it's all over the shop, as you may tell. And I'm like, forget to say what day it is, forget to explain things. There's chocolate on my mouth. There's always chocolate around my mouth. Like I'm literally I never not have chocolate in a day, and it's always all over me. Honestly, everyone's like, Kate, like you're actually a joke. Like my friends are like, Kate, you're a joke. But yeah, that's kind of everything. I'm going into week 10 of my cut, which I'm really, really enjoying. I'm kind of documenting that on my Instagram page if you want to see it, and I'm feeling really good. My food's still really high. Cardio is 4-30 minutes a week, which is so fine, and steps are 12,000 a day. And I'm just really, really, really enjoying it. I think it's because I have a lot more muscle this time around, because I spent 11 months in a surplus, so I do have a lot more muscle this time around, so it's really cool to actually start seeing that. So yeah, I'm gonna leave you go because I will literally be chatting here for ages. But I really, really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like, share to your stories, to your Instagrams, I'd really appreciate it, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye guys.